Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Laurence Strubbe, and I'm a PhD student from the research from the Biosystem Control Group of Professor Evelien Volke. Today, I will answer the following question. Could the treatment capacity of a continuous wastewater treatment plant be increased with aerobic granular sludge? If you are familiar with aerobic granular sludge, then I presume that you are all thinking yes, of course. But the answer is not that simple, and I will explain you why. Flanders is quite densely populated, and so is the world. So we need to use our space efficiently, also when we are implementing wastewater treatment installations. However, currently, almost all municipal wastewater is treated in continuous flow reactors with activated sludge. Activated sludge has a low settling velocity, so we need space-consuming settlers, and the biomass concentrations in these installations are low. Moreover, in the near future, the effluent criteria will become stricter, and they predicted that in the coming 20 years, we will produce 30% more wastewater. So not only space, but also energy and costs will increase even more. But if we could replace all the activated sludge plants by aerobic granular sludge plants, then we would only require 1/4 of the surface. And we could also reduce then energy and costs. And the reason for that is because of bacteria that are not growing anymore in the dispersed flocks, but in dense granules. These dense granules, they settle well, so we don't need space-consuming settlers anymore. And moreover, these granules are characterized by different zones, an aerobic outer layer and an anoxic core. So different reactions can take place in one granule instead of in different reactors. This process is already implemented successfully on full scale worldwide. However, not in continuous flow reactors, but in batch reactors. And that's because the batch-wise operation is the most efficient operation to get stable granules. But what about our current infrastructure? Can we combine the advantages of aerobic granular sludge and our current infrastructure, namely continuous flow reactors, to increase the treatment capacity without building new installations? So a new research topic was born. All over the world, they are investigating on how to get stable granules in continuous flow reactors. And we believe they will achieve to do this. But isn't it important to first take a step back and to see what is the effect of aerobic granular sludge in continuous flow reactors? Will they really increase the treatment capacity? Or they're not able to do this. So this is what I investigated. There are two effects that we already know. The first one is the higher settling velocity. So the current settlers will have a higher capacity, so more biomass will be present in the reactors. And possibly this will positively influence the treatment capacity and the energy use. Another effect is diffusion limitation. Diffusion is concentration driven, and the concentration in continuous flow reactors is as low as the effluent quality. So this can probably limit conversion rates. But on the other hand, diffusion limitation of oxygen creates different zones in one granule, so this stimulates simultaneously nutrient removal. So a clear effect on treatment capacity and energy use is not known. So what I investigated is the overall effect of both aspects via model simulations. So let's start with scenario one, the scenario that we all know, the continuous system with activated sludge. So we have a fixed design and a fixed operational strategy, and we focus on nitrogen removal. So the goal is to reach the effluent quality and to see what is the maximal treatment capacity and related energy use and costs for this treatment installation. We consider a fixed biomass concentration in the installation of 4 kg per cubic meter. And if we increase the COD effluent load, then we see that at a certain point, the effluent nitrogen concentration is exceeding the criteria concentration. That's because the SRT is becoming too low with an increase in COD effluent load, and the biology is failing, so nitrification is limited. Further on, also the suspended solids and the effluent is reaching the criteria. And that's because of failure of the settler, because at a certain point, the settler is not able anymore to separate the particulates from the clean effluent. So let's put these two red points in following graph. So you see for a biomass concentration of 4 kilograms per cubic meter, we see one point where the maximal treatment capacity is limited by the failure of biology, and another point where it's limited by the failure of the settler. So we repeated the same simulations for all the different biomass concentrations, and we become following graph. So you see the dashed line. The dashed line show the points where you have the failure of nitrification, and the solid line is determined by the failure of the settler. So below the dashed line, we find a green zone where all effluent criteria are met. And and above the dashed line, we find a red zone where the criteria are not met. In between those graphs, the suspended solids concentrations and the effluent are still okay, but above the solid line, they are not okay anymore. So if we have a look to the trend of these graphs, we see that for an increasing biomass concentration, nitrification, the failure of nitrification increases, or the maximal treatment capacity for failure of nitrification increases. And that's just because with a higher biomass concentration, we can nitrify more. The opposite is true for failure of the settler. So at a higher biomass concentration, it's more difficult for the settler to separate the particulates from the clean effluent. So at a certain point, the settler is failing before nitrification does, and that's in fact our maximal point, which is the maximal treatment capacity of the insulation at a biomass concentration of 5 kilograms per cubic meter. So now let's compare the reference case with the case where we have better settling sludge. So imagine it's hypothetical that we can just increase the settling velocity of our sludge. What will happen with the maximal treatment capacity, the energy, and the costs? So here you see again the graph, activated sludge compared with better settling sludge. And then you see that the optimal point is 40% higher compared to activated sludge. So it means that if we put better settling sludge in our continuous flow installations, that we can treat 40% more wastewater. And also the energy use is positive because we use 7% less energy. We know that better settling velocity will always go together with diffusion limitation, so the case of aerobic granular sludge. So let's see what happens now if we put aerobic granular sludge in the system, what will happen with maximal treatment capacity, the energy use, and the costs. So now we see that treatment capacity could only be increased with 7%. And what's not positive is that the energy use is increased with 40%. And that's because we needed to increase our oxygen set points from 2 grams per cubic meter to 4 grams per cubic meter because of diffusion limitation, because otherwise no reactions were taking place. But maybe you were already thinking that the design and operational strategy that we used was not the optimal one for aerobic granular sludge. And indeed, we proposed an improved design and an improved strategy to make use of the advantages of aerobic granular sludge. So we removed the anoxic reactor compartment and used it as an extra aerobic compartment. And we decreased the oxygen set point from 2 to 1.5 grams per cubic meter to make use of the diffusion limitation and to promote simultaneously nitrification, denitrification. And then let's see what happens now with maximal treatment capacity and the energy use. We see that we can increase the treatment capacity with 20% and the energy use is decreased with 10% because of the lower oxygen set point and also because we didn't need an internal recycle anymore to the anoxic tank. So finally, the answer on the question if we could increase the treatment capacity of a continuous wastewater treatment plant with aerobic granular sludge. At the first sight, yes, because we have better settling sludge, higher biomass concentration, and thus higher treatment capacity. But maybe no, because we also have diffusion limitation, and this limits our conversion rates. But finally, yes, if we improve our process operation and design, we can make use of simultaneously nitrification and denitrification, and therefore improve our treatment capacity and also our energy use. So thank you for your attention, and if there are questions, I would be happy to answer them.